When the year comes to an end and the snow starts to fall, the most awaited winter ritual, apart from having hot chocolate, is hitting the slopes for skiing. People all over the world travel to snow-covered hills, but if you don't want to ski with a crowd and dream of escaping to a winter wonderland of luxury, then you have got to check out these ski resorts we're gonna show you. Stick around until the end to know about Princess Diana's favorite resort. Number 10, Aspen, Colorado. Known as one of the most popular skiing destinations, Aspen is everything with luxury. Perched on a ski-in, ski-out spot, at the base of the famed Aspen Highlands Resort, members here are treated like ski royalty, with a bevy of staff members ready to wait for hand and foot on your every need. Not only do guests here have access to some of the best skiing in the world, along with luxurious accommodations and five-star dining, but the staff here aims to fulfill every wish and desire of the customer. They bend over backwards to make this elegant sanctuary one of the premier spots in the world. The resort is renowned as one of the world's premier hotel spas, with a heated outdoor pool and hot tubs overlooking stunning Aspen Mountains. Number 9, Verbier, Switzerland. Last in alphabetical order, but certainly not last on the list, Verbier is one of those ski resorts whose reputation precedes itself. The stereotype is that Verbier is a hangout for minor royals, England rugby players, and James Blunt, all of which is true. Blunt even has a lift named after him. However, the place is much more than just a glorified skiing resort. Verbier boasts one of the world's largest ski areas, with the lifts from the main village offering access to a huge network that links Lazumaz, Nendaz, Vaisonaz, and Thion. Together, they form what's known as the Four Vallées, which is home not only to some of the best skiing you'll find anywhere in Europe, but also some of the longest ski runs anywhere in the world. The town isn't cheap, but again, what is in Switzerland? The reason all those rich and famous folk love it here is the combination of incredible restaurants, epic powder, and some of the most naturally exciting slopes you'll find anywhere on the planet. Number 8, Zermatt, Switzerland. While we're exploring the resorts of Switzerland, here is another one. With the majestic Matterhorn always in view, Zermatt boasts unparalleled scenes at every turn and dates back over 500 years. Full of romantic neighborhoods and quiet corners, it is the quintessential alpine resort visitors fall in love with again and again. A peaceful yet wild mountain world, it is entirely carefree, and the shops, cafes, bars, and luxurious hotel lounges make Zermatt pulse with life. With 220 miles of pistes and lifts, which go up to the Klein Matterhorn at 3,883 meters, visitors can soak up the panoramic view of the 4,000 meter mountains. Everything here is heavenly, but to experience this heaven, you have to be God's favorite, meaning you have to be rich. Number 7, Vail, Colorado. This may easily be one of the most iconic resorts in the world. The third biggest resort in the United States, Vail offers 195 trails and 35 lifts over 5,317 acres with a vertical drop of 3,450 feet. In the summer, the resort offers excellent hiking and biking along with its year-round shopping and ski village amenities. Its proximity to Eagle Airport also makes it an ideal destination for the super elite to get to. Overall, Vail does a great job in combining luxury glam from the movies with some of the best skiing on the continent. Number 6, Courchevel, France. The highest of Courchevel's five villages, officially simply called Courchevel, is a prestigious place to stay in this French resort at one end of the 370-mile Trois Vallées ski area. Still often known by its former moniker, 1850, it is home to huge numbers of four-star, five-star, and palace status hotels, luxury chalets, and some pricey shops. Courchevel has lots of fast gondolas and chairlifts, and 1850 suits both beginners and intermediates well. For gourmets, Courchevel has 12 Michelin stars spread over 7 restaurants and a long history of lofty food standards. And for seriously upmarket clubbing, LaGrange pumps out music until 5 a.m. Number 5. Gstaad, Switzerland. With 7 different mountains in the area, the town of Gstaad is a skier's paradise. With 136 miles of trails, 57 lifts, and a vertical drop of 5,488 feet at the highest resort, it is one of the most equipped resorts for skiing in Switzerland. In the summer, Gstaad offers just as many activities, boasting over 186 miles of hiking trails in addition to mountain biking, golfing, cycling, and all of the scenic lakes and rivers to discover. This fairy tale destination is less than 2 hours away from Geneva, making it easily accessible for vacationers. The Gstaad valleys give off a cozy small town feeling, while at the same time offering five-star hotels, restaurants, and some of the finest shopping in Switzerland. Number 4. Whistler, Canada. Whistler offers renowned service and convenience that leaves more time for exhilarating adventures in the Alpine. It is a year-round getaway nestled at the base of North America's largest ski resort, Whistler's Blackcomb. Guests can ski in and out with the ski concierge, treat their senses at award-winning spas, and rest in one of the newly renovated 273 guest rooms, suites, townhouses, or 20 luxurious private residences, each with a fireplace and most with balconies. Named for the curvature on the side of a ski or snowboard, the resort's restaurant, Sidecut, has a spectacular alpine location with glorious views of the local mountains and a brilliant fire-lit setting. Number 3. St. Moritz, Switzerland. Welcome to the world capital of winter glamour. Walking the streets in high season, it would seem that Prada and Bogner are the sole manufacturers of ski wear and that mink fur coats are mandatory. St. Moritz is divided into 3 villages, Dorf, Bad, and Celerina, around or near Lake St. Moritz, with Dorf having the pick of shops, nightlife, and restaurants. However, there's more to St. Moritz than bling. Its position close to the border with Italy and a ski area high point of 3,305 meters gives it a rare combination of both snow and sun reliability. It was also the first all-around winter sports resort in the world and boasts a myriad of on and off snow attractions, from skating and bobsleigh to polo, horse racing, and cricket on the frozen lake. Number 2. Cortina d'Ampezzo, Italy. With 12 resorts in the region and 4 directly surrounding the town, with 74 miles of trails and 36 lifts in Cortina d'Ampezzo alone, there is plenty for any level of skier to explore. Tucked away in the heart of Dolomites, Cortina d'Ampezzo is a town that has been around for 1,000 years and has a lengthy ski history to go along with it. The summertime transforms this winter wonderland into a just as stunning summer paradise with a multitude of biking and hiking trails across the mountains. Already hosting the Winter Olympics once in 1958, Milan is scheduled to host the 2026 Winter Olympics, with Cortina again asserting itself as the center of winter sports competition. Number 1. Lech, Austria. Few resorts have a more exclusive image than Lech. Princess Diana was its most famous fan, and the other past visitors include the Jordanian royal family, the Dutch royal family, and Monaco's Princess Caroline. But despite its blue-blooded guest line and no shortage of five-star hotels, Lec is far from showy, as it has retained its traditional charm. The Hotel Am Hof Schneider is one of the three superior five-star hotels in Lec. This hedonistic hostelry was even favored by Princess Diana in the last years of her life. The current extended farmhouse dates back to the 20s, and the Schneider family can trace its origins in the Lec Valley back to 1451. Am Hof even has personal winter sports instructors, ready to teach all you newbies the tricks of the trade. If you have money to burn, there's no better cold place than this. Which one of these ski resorts did you like the most? And have you ever been to any of them? Let us know in the comments. And if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel.